I want to move people and make people feel uneasy and question their whole existence with my visuals. I just want to build worlds where people can live if they're sick of this one. This was mental. This wasn't supposed to be a video. This was probably the craziest night of my life to this day. Just had this idea where like, let's just do something dangerous and unifying all at the same time. When Nevermind the Bollocks is the Sex Pistols came out, they had a boat party and it got shut down by the police. So I was like, let's do a boat party and then I'm gonna turn up on the Thames at one of the bank stops on a little punk boat and be like, meet me outside the House of Parliament. I got a surprise for you because there's a song coming out. And I was like, cool, 500 people might turn up. We got there. And it was like, what, 2,000, 3,000? And we got on and it was just pandemonium. And I was like, sick. And then people got on the boat and it was so cool to just like play a punk show on a boat. The boat was like, vroom, vroom, vroom. It's like, oh, it's a bit choppy on the Thames today, isn't it? It's like, is it fucked? There's 100 people pogoing on a boat. And to see people running down the banks of the Thames and running out like the bridges and running with their mates while we were on this boat. And then we got there and I seen there's Out for the Underrated. You've projected it illegally. Some dude's in a van. I was like, yo, you got a strong projector? He's like, yeah. He's like, do you want to do that for me? He's like, yeah. And then projected it on the House of Parliament and the whole bridge, Westminster Bridge, was like rammed and it just worked. And I was just like with a megaphone like, ah, and there's like kids on the bridge, kids on the banks, kids on the boat, and everyone was just shouting in unity because they were angry and we felt heard. And then internationally everyone started talking about it and it went insane. And it was probably like one of the proudest moments of my whole career, because I was like, this is what I want Yungblud to be about. It's about fucking culture and it's about we are here together to get our voices heard. And we could not be ignored that night. Oh, brother, I'll remember that moment for the rest of my life, and they will. And it was like, no matter how big this may get, look what we just did. No matter if it all ends tomorrow, that is cemented in film, in time. That is a moment, and we did that. And every time I call my fan base, they respond above my expectations every single time. So strange to direct a video myself. No one was gonna see this video like I did, I don't think. That's why I needed to do it myself. I wanted an abstract video that was gonna make you cry yet make you feel like you could do anything all at the same time. This song is so emotional. When I wrote this song, I grew up 2 years in 2 minutes.
I've got to the point where I don't even want to be seen with him in public. I'm embarrassed. I'm so...
That shot was so hard to pull off. I'm almost in the same position, yet the surroundings change. You know what I mean? It's like I'm just sat there like this. Anxiety feels like that. It feels like everything's a blur. It feels like everything around you is not real. You're not actually present. So that's when you can hurt yourself. It doesn't seem real. And this is real. Depression and anxiety is a real thing. And it's all right to be that way. You got to speak about it. And I edited it. I hated editing. I hate it. It's awful. Because I'm like, what if I choose the wrong shot? And then we got there in the end. And out of the abyss. Calm me down. I remember I referenced that part in Harry Potter. Do you remember when Dumbledore and Harry, when he gets killed by Voldemort, and he's in that in-between at King's Cross Station? That was the exact reference for this. That I want it to look like that. I want it to be like, where are we? Did he just die? And then we go in. The reason why I wore white and then black is to kind of resemble, is this is like the in-between. You know what I mean? It's unrealistic. It's not reality. It's like me subconscious. This is what's going on in me head. This is like me brain. But I love how English this video is. You know what I mean? This album is so British. I want it to be so English. Because I've been all over the world. But I want people to know I'm English because I'm proud to be British. You know what I mean? I love cups of tea. And I love shitty garages. And weeds. So, like, I want it to be like Dom in his Adidas jacket on his BMX waiting outside the shop. Asking someone to go in and get him some Scrumpy Jack cider. That shot is the most emotional shot in the video for me. I proper tear up when I see that. When the bear's like, I got you, man. I want to do a video with a teddy bear that represents kind of my inner confidence and my inner strive to get better, because no matter how hard it may get, it can always get better if you want it to. And then I wanted to take that bear away halfway through and do that Fight Club thing when it was almost never there. It was almost me all the time. And it was about a time in my life that I didn't want to be here anymore. I genuinely didn't. But I got over it, and I wanted to amplify the feeling when you're experiencing depression, that you feel like you're underwater. People can be screaming at you, but you just don't really hear it. I'm so proud of this. I think it's one of the best videos I've ever made, and I loved it. I loved every minute of it, even though I didn't sleep for 2 weeks. I can't sleep. LA was like, it's very sunny. I'm a little flower. I like to be watered by the rain. And I was trapped in a house with my guitar player, and me drummer, and me photographer. And Tom Hallen is a genius. He's very much integral to the photos and the visuals in Yungblud. Like, I don't know what I'd do without him. And he was just like, we've got it. Let's just do something crazy. Let's just film being in the house and just, like, don't wreck your brain. It'll be all right. We're in a weird time of life. This video I wanted to be so relatable to everybody. So we're just like, I'm just stuck in the house just like you. And I'm going stir fucking crazy. My body clocks everywhere. And we wanted it to get a bit weird. And I was like literally watching like ASAP Rocky and ASAP Mob's videos and the butterfly effect Travis Scott. Like with all the colours and the colour changes. We just did it. We just literally spent 3 days in the house messing about and having fun. I wanted to make a video that would just make people smile. Like feel my smile right now. Literally, that was our house. There was a weird Jesus crucifix on the wall. And we were just having fun, like, how can we make these cuts seem cool? And how can we leave a GoPro out and watch the sun actually do that? And then we can change colour every time. First shot was a fucking nightmare because no one got what I wanted. No one understood me. I was like, I need it to change every time the sun does it. And I nicked that from a Tame Impala concert. You watch Tame Impala, they do it and the sun does this. And then by the end, it's like a line because it's going that quickly. I had not seen my mum and dad in ages. And I literally called them from the UK. I was like, I need to wake up. Mum was like, I want to sleep. I was like, let me screen record you. My mum's like, got a specs on, like, you can't put me in a video looking like this. I've got me specs on. It's 2 in the morning. But I did. Because I'm a brat. See my mum and father die. Do you know what I mean? It's such a proper warts and all video. You can see me spots. You can see our bedrooms. Adam's just playing his guitar on an Apple Mac in his room. And this is shot on an iPhone. And everyone's like, not got their hair done. In the clothes they've been wearing for 5 days. Just real. She was only 17. This song defines the community of Yungblud, I think. And this video was not the video I imagined when I wrote this song. I had the idea, we're putting makeup on. And everyone around us is going to try and stop us from putting that makeup on. This is my generation, man, and we're going to put that makeup on. Even if we get battered and bruised. Because we're going to express ourselves no matter what. You can see from the beginning, everyone has a different story to tell. And that's why it was so magic. Pete, trans man, to Jordan, a black guy with white hands around his neck, and then Jasmine, the black female, taking those hands off. Jenna, the white girl, it wasn't just fighting, it was someone touching her there inappropriately and creepily. There's so many metaphors in this video that just came as we were shooting it because the cast was so incredible, because everyone is facing their own war every day. I sat with them, kind of was like, yo, these lyrics mean something to me, but they can mean anything to anyone. This song is like, if you feel like you're an alien, and you're wondering, is there any life on this planet that you're on? Yeah, there fucking is. Because I'm here and you're here and we're both breathing. And you can see it in their eyes. That's why I just wanted it to be like a school photo. Tom, my photographer, I was like, I need you to spit in my face. Because obviously, like, we were in a pandemic and we all had to get tested. It had to be Tom because he lives in my household. You know what I mean? So I was like, I need you to spit in my face. And Tom's polite as fuck. And I was like, I need you to green in me eyeball. And then he did. Every morning she will wake up with another plan. Yeah, I'm on that shot there. I just thought, I looked at him. Every time if you looked at me, I'm screaming in the faces behind the camera. Going, think about a time when someone put you down or someone hurt you or someone made you feel like you've been punched in the stomach. And look at them right now and go, I am defiant. Do you feel like you're relevant? He actually hit me in the face. We had to do it. It was hilarious because we had a stuntman there. The reference was Sherlock Holmes. You know, in the Robert Downey Jr. films where you see every ripple. I was like, how do we do that? He's like, they're going to have to hit you. I was like, sick. The stuntman was doing it, like, soft. I was like, come on, you can hit me harder than that because you look shy. It was like, he just went. And I was like, all right, then. Crack. I was like, oh, shit, that hurt. Every time someone did a take, it became so much bigger than what I had in my head. I didn't even imagine it like this. It's like, proper makes me cry nearly every time. Fuck, man. Bro, this fucking proper fucks me up, man, at the end, like, every time. I put that scene there, because when you're watching it, you see yourself. And that's why I did it for such a long time. You can be like, oh, fuck, that's me. And that's who I am. God. Whew. Proper gooses, man. I was born in a messed up century. We shot this video in the middle of nowhere, so it was like the middle of the day. Like, I remember we'd come from, like, Austin and flown on a night flight. I had a 2 hours sleep. And then we're in the middle of, like, LA somewhere in, like, a shed. Bro, how did it feel holding a gun? This whole song stemmed from that. This whole idea was guns kill kids, but can the kids kill the guns? That was the metaphor. I was in America at the time. I was like, I want to be a baby with a diaper holding a gun. Because that's how fucked it is. Young people can buy guns. That's a fact. And I wanted it to be dangerous as fuck, this video. I remember people were like, that's a bit close, innit? I was like, yeah, it fucking is. Because it has to be. That's how you get heard. I ain't going to tiptoe around the subject. That's what I said. I'm going to tell the truth even if it gets me in trouble. I'm so fucking proud of this video. I keep watching it and be like, this is mad imagery. That's what I want. I want a powerful imagery that would just make people think and make people try to understand my generation. And I think why this song got so big, even though it's so outrageous lyrically and so offensive to some people, is because it's saying what people are thinking. Hi, nice. I love that image. Like dancing on my own grave. It's like it has so many meanings. That it's the old person I used to be. It's the person they want me fucking dead. They want me gone. The people don't, like, at this time, people didn't get me. People were like, this guy's just corrupting fucking people. And it was like, no, listen to your fucking daughter, listen to your son, listen to your fucking non-binary kid. This is the way we're thinking. Actually, you're disrupting what the cycle of our lives, and you're disrupting our happiness. It's not just about gun violence. It's about everything. It's about us changing it. And every stigma will go out of the window because we just don't want to be divided. Don't want to.